Have you ever wondered what kind of colors were used in Scandinavia during the Viking Age? And which kind of materials they extracted the colors from? If so, then continue on watching and you will be able to add the authentic Viking colors to your own palette. The colors that we are going to take a look at are those that were used on wood and other similar objects. None of these colors were used for textile production. We know of 17 different colors that were used, and these colors have been found by examining pieces of wood from King Gorm's burial site in Jelling and a plank from a stave church in Herning, Denmark. The examinations have shown that the Vikings used bold and bright colors. These bright and beautiful colors were probably a status symbol and used in order to stand out from the rest, something that seems to have been common practice. The colors they wore, the houses they had, would have shown everyone that this family was having enough wealth to color their belongings in some of the most expensive and rare colors available. The color pigments came from various sources, for instance, ochre and charcoal, which were mixed together with a binding material, such as milk, egg, or linseed oil. Some colors were rarer than others, and some were produced locally, while others were imported. The cheapest color was black, and was made from crushed charcoal, something that most people would have had access to. Notice how similar the words are in all of the Scandinavian languages. Many of the words are also close to Old Norse, which enables most people to read and understand some or parts of the old text. Because I want to show you the difference in the sounds from Old Norse and Danish, I'm gonna try and pronounce the colors in Old Norse and then in Danish. In Old Norse, black is pronounced svarta. And compared to Danish today, in Danish you say sort. So in Old Norse it's svarta, in Danish it's sort. Another common color was brown, which was made from ochre pigments. These could be found in streams, so maybe they found a couple while fishing or bathing. In Old Norse, brown is brun, and in Danish it's brun. The brighter yellow color had to be imported, since these ornaments do not occur in places such as Denmark. They were probably purchased from merchants along the River Rhine or in Constantinople, since yellow ornaments could be found in Central Europe and the Middle East. If you do not know, Constantinople was called Miklagård by the Vikings. In Old Norse, yellow is gulor, and in Danish it's gul. White was quite a common color, since white lead was produced and traded in most areas in and outside of Scandinavia. White lead may also have been used by a vulva to paint her face white, and perhaps she also used crushed charcoal around her eyes. A vulva is a woman who practices shamanism. One of the reasons for this assumption of her coloring her face is that this has also been done in other cultures in Europe, and there has also been found white lead in a grave of a vulva at the Viking fortress Fyrkat in Denmark. In Old Norse, white is pronounced hvitja, and in Danish it is pronounced hvid. The blue color was made from vivianite, which is an iron mineral that is common throughout Europe. However, it is unknown if this was considered a cheap or an expensive color in Scandinavia, at least at this time. In Old Norse, blue is blå, and in Danish it's blå. Copper hydroxycarbonate was used to make the color green, and it may have been imported to Scandinavia, and would therefore have been relatively expensive. Green is almost the same in Old Norse and Danish. In Old Norse it's grøn, and in Danish grøn. The bright red was made from cinnabar, which was imported from Spain or Central Europe. This color has been used since the ancient past in many areas in Europe, and it was quite a popular color. The dark red color was made from iron oxide. It was quite a common material, and it was probably not that expensive to buy. To be honest, I'm not that good at pronouncing red in Old Norse. That is something that Dr. Jackson Crawford is probably much better at. But I'm gonna give it a try anyway. So in Old Norse, red is rødvar, and in Danish it's rød. Again, I just want to say, if you want to hear the words in Old Norse pronounced better than I'm able to do, then please watch the video with Dr. Jackson Crawford where he pronounces the words in Old Norse. I'm just great at doing it in Danish since, well, I'm Danish. And I'm not saying that Dr. Jackson was found frozen in a cave near Reykjavik, where he has been since the Viking Age, so he already knew the language. No, no, I'm saying he has studied the language and he's pretty good at it. That's all I'm saying. Okay, let's continue. Please keep in mind, before you start coloring everything that you own with these colors, that the colors may not be exactly correct, but they are the closest ones that the researchers have come up with to date. The colors are, in fact, so close to what the colors are believed to have been used by the Vikings, that the Royal Viking Hall in Lyra was on the verge to be painted with the use of them. But as of right now, it has not been painted, but I do hope it will happen sometime in the future. If it were to happen, the Viking Hall might be painted entirely white with the use of quicklime, which there have been found traces of at the Royal Hall in Tisø, but also at this one in Lyra. The benefits of using quicklime was probably to help insulate the building and have a brighter interior of the house during the long and dark winters. The white color would also have been clearly visible in the landscape from afar. It is possible that the white color was the base color, and the other colors were used to decorate the house or other objects. For instance, pillars that had been carved to depict the gods. It is also important to remember that the Viking Age spanned over a long period of time, something that we often forget, and the colors available or the way they painted the houses could have changed quite a lot. Just think about the interior design of the 60s, 70s or 80s. If you want to use these colors for something creative, then you can find the color code on my website. The link is in the description. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up and please consider sharing it with a friend. See you next time for another video. Have a great week. Thank you for watching.